Now next one, rules for creating identifiers or rules for providing identifier names. As we are discussing previous video, identifier is nothing but it is a user provided name or user assigned names. According to conventions, we must provide some meaningful names to the identifiers, but it is not compulsory. What is the mandatory rules here? We are discussing mandatory rules for creating identifiers. After that, we are discussing what is the conventions for providing identifier names. First rule, identifier can contain only alphabets, digits or underscores. Second rule, identifier cannot be start with digits. It should be start with either alphabets or underscores. Max length of identifier depends upon compiler setting. It must be between 1 to 32. Identifier name can be up to 32 characters wide, but the identifier name settings depends up to compiler to compiler. It is changeable. We can change identifier length also. Next one, keywords cannot be used as identifier names. Some predefined constants or macros are available in C, like null character null, end of file character eof, or some predefined macros are available which cannot be used as identifier names. Like that, we are discussing all rules one by one in details. First rule, identifier can contain only alphabets, uppercase alphabets A, B, C, up to Z. Means whenever we are providing identifier names can contains alphabets, uppercase as well as lowercase, or digits between 0 to 9, 0, 1, 2, 3, up to 9, or underscore. Only that set of characters can be used as a identifier names, but still recommended to use identifier should be starts with either alphabets or underscore. Identifier cannot starts with digits. Like we are providing some identifier name like a data type. Identifier names is nothing but it is a maybe variable names, function names, like that. Integer, we are providing some user defined name as m1. It is valid declarations because here m1 is a identifier which is start with alphabet, lower alphabet m. But if you are providing declarations like that 1m, it is invalid declarations or invalid identifier declarations. Clear? Identifier can be starts with underscore, like underscore m1. It is valid declarations. Even though we can provide only underscore, single underscore, maybe multiple underscore, it is valid identifier declarations, like that. But identifier cannot contains space. Next one, identifier also may be function names, like we are declaring some function name as a void m1, m2 or something, get salary, like that. Here get salary is also function names, or we can say it is a identifier. We are using return type something integer, whatever. Here get salary is also identifier. It is function declarations. Next one, identifier cannot starts with digits. It should be starts with alphabets or underscores, like that. Now third point, identifier cannot contains space, like you're declaring some variable like a integer student marks. Student marks, it is valid variable declarations or identifier declaration. Again here student marks is an identifier name because it is user defined names, but it cannot contains spaces, like student space marks. It is invalid identifier name because here we are using or providing some space in between student and marks, therefore it is invalid identifier name, but it is valid. Next one, same as identifier names. If identifier name contains more than one word, then it can be logically separated by using underscore, like that. It is valid declarations of identifier names. There is no errors. Like that. By using these conventions, we can declare different identifier names. One more case, if we are declaring some identifier like that, student, comma, marks. It is valid identifier name because here we are declaring two identifiers within a single declaration. Student is a first identifier, marks is a second another identifier. Means here we are declaring two variables. First variable name is student, second variable name is marks. Means multiple variable declarations are separated by comma. Here comma is not a part of identifier name. Here comma is a part of syntax which is used to separating multiple declarations provided within a single statements. Next rule, reserve words cannot be used as identifiers. What do you mean by reserve words? Reserve words nothing but it is a keywords. We cannot use keywords as an identifier. Here we are writing some keyword name as do. As we know, do is a keyword which is used for creating loops. Therefore, it is invalid declaration. Same as integer, while. Again, it is invalid variable declarations. Or if you want to creating some functions like a void, function name is if. Again, it is invalid function declaration because here we are using function name as if, which is keyword. Keywords cannot be used as a reserve words because it has already predefined meanings. Therefore, if we cannot change its meanings. Therefore, keywords cannot be used as identifier names. Next point, fifth point, predefined macros cannot be used as identifier. As we know, in C language, a lot of macros are already defined, like a null, this value is already defined as 0. Same as end of file character EOF, its value is already defined as -1, like that, and so on. Same as underscore time underscore double underscore continuously like that, time, date, file, and so on. These all are predefined macros available in C. Predefined macros cannot be used as identifier declarations like integer EOF. It is a macro declaration which is processed before compilation. Means its conversion or logical meaning is equivalent to like that integer. Before compilation, EOF is replaced by their value as -1. It becomes like that. Therefore, as we know, it is -1 is an invalid identifier name. Therefore, we cannot use predefined macros as a identifier names. Next one. The max length of identifier names depends upon a compiler declaration, depends upon a compiler settings or editor settings, or editor setting provided by compiler by default. Still, identifier can contains only identifier cannot be a maximum characters up to 32 characters wide, or identifier name can contains between 1 to 32 characters, or depends upon compiler setting because it is a default length can be changeable. By default max length is 32, or depends upon a compiler setting, but it is a changeable. How to changing maximum identifier length? By using Turbo C editor. Like this is some Turbo C editor. In Turbo C editor, in beginning you can see some menu options like a file, edit, and so on. In the middle of them, some option is available called as also options. Then now click on this options. Just is options button by click karo, options ke kisme again next option show hoga idhar compiler. Then click on compiler submenu. After click on compiler, new window will be opened as a source. Then click on source. जैसे आप ये सोर्स मेन्यू पर क्लिक करोगे इमीडिएटली सब मेन्यू और सब डायलॉग बॉक्स ओपन होगा. इन दैट केस सम मेन्यूज अलोंग विद हियर सम टेक्स्ट बॉक्स इज अवेलेबल एज अ आइडेंटिफायर लेंथ. नेम ऑफ दिस टेक्स्ट बॉक्स लेबल इज आइडेंटिफायर लेंथ. डिफॉल्ट लेंथ मे बी सेट एज 32 और सम बटन सेज ओके कैंसिल लाइक दैट. यू कैन चेंज डिफॉल्ट लेंथ बाई यूजिंग दिस ऑप्शन. अगेन क्लिक ऑन ऑप्शंस, क्लिक ऑन कंपाइलर सोर्स. जैसे आप सोर्स पर सब मेन्यू में क्लिक करेंगे देन शो किया न्यू डायलॉग बॉक्स विद आइडेंटिफाई लेंथ. हियर डिफॉल्ट लेंथ इज डिस्प्लेड. यू कैन चेंज इट्स मे बी वी कैन प्रोवाइड लेंथ बिटवीन 1 to 32. If you are providing identify length is 8, then what happens? Then you can use up to 8 characters. Within an identify name is function name or variable names can contains providing only 8 characters like that. For examples, related to this concept, we are discussing some examples after that sessions. Next one. Identifiers are case sensitive. What do you mean by case sensitive properties? One more thing, within a function or within a block, we are declaring some function like a void main. Means within a function or within a block, same name se multiple identifiers declare karna possible. For example, we are declaring some identifier name as x with data type as int. Again, we are declaring one more identifier or variable names again x. It is invalid because there may be an ambiguity problem between x. If you are assigning some value here like x equals to 10 and x equals to 5, then there may be a chance of ambiguity problem. If you are displaying value of x, then compiler will reach compile time error because in this case same name se identifiers kitne create hue 2 x again x, therefore it is invalid. Means within a single block, block means opening or curly braces, within a block same name se multiple or more than one identifiers declare karna possible nahi hua. Therefore next one, identifiers are case sensitive. Same name se variables declare karna possible or identifier declare karna possible agar aapne different different cases ke form mein write ke like a int a small x or we are using some different name, some variable name as number. It is valid identifier. We are declaring one more variable integer number. Again it is valid because C is a case sensitive programming language. Lower case is differed from upper case names. Here we are declaring different frame variables, one more combination n is upper case, remaining are in lower case number. It is again valid declaration. इस केस में देखा जाए तो सेम नाम से थ्री वेरिएबल डिफाइन किए, लेकिन तीनों के केसेस में कैरेक्टर्स के केस कैसे हैं डिफरेंट डिफरेंट, इसलिए इसके मीनिंग्स भी कैसे होंगे डिफरेंट डिफरेंट. सेम एज वी कैन डिक्लेयर लाइक दैट एन स्मॉल यू कैपिटल एम स्मॉल बी कैपिटल आर लाइक दैट. दीज ऑल वेरिएबल्स आर डिफाइंड फ्रॉम ईच अदर. In that case, we are providing four variable declaration. It is valid declaration with respect to identifier because C is a case sensitive programming language. Next one, in C language, we know some functions are available as predefined manner like a CLR, FCR, printf, scanf, like that. We can use predefined function name as an identifier. It is valid in C. But it is not recommended to provide predefined function names as a identifier names because there may be chance of some ambiguity problems. Next one, according to conventions, what is the conventions for creating identifiers? First of all, what is the difference between rules and conventions? Rules must be followed by compiler, or rules are compiler provided rules. अगर आप किसी प्रोग्राम्स को या आइडेंटिफायर को क्रिएट करने के केसेस में रूल्स को फॉलो नहीं करो देन देयर क्या होगा, कंपाइल टाइम एरर्स। कन्वेंशंस आर इंडस्ट्री डिफाइंड रूल्स, इंडस्ट्री मीन्स सॉफ्टवेयर कंपनीज। अगर कंपनीज मीन्स अगर आपने कन्वेंशंस को फॉलो नहीं किया है देन इस केस में प्रोग्राम का कंपाइलेशन भी पॉसिबल है, एग्जीक्यूशन भी पॉसिबल, देयर इज नो एरर, बट इट इज नॉट रिकमेंडेड बाई सॉफ्टवेयर इंडस्ट्रीज। अगर आप किसी सॉफ्टवेयर इंडस्ट्री में वर्क करें देन कन्वेंशंस फॉलो करना कंपल्सरी हुआ। नेक्स्ट वन, व्हाट इज द यूज ऑफ कन्वेंशंस, कन्वेंशंस आर प्रोवाइडेड जनरली टू मेक अवर कोड एज मोर रीडेबल्स कंपेयर टू नॉर्मल कोड। आइडेंटिफायर मस्ट बी प्रोवाइडेड एज सम मीनिंगफुल नाउन्स और मीनिंगफुल नेम्स, मीन्स सेल्फ डिस्क्रिप्टिव नेम्स, इवन दो वी कैन क्रिएट वेरिएबल नेम्स लाइक इफ यू वॉन्ट टू स्टोरिंग सैलरी ऑफ द पर्सन यू कैन क्रिएट वेरिएबल नेम लाइक एक्स, इनसाइड एक्स यू कैन स्टोर ऑल्सो सैलरी, बट इट इज नॉट टू यूज रिकमेंडेड। वी मस्ट प्रोवाइड सम मीनिंगफुल नेम्स, देयरफॉर मीनिंगफुल नेम्स प्रोवाइड्स रीडेबल कोड और इट विल इंक्रीज रीडेबिलिटी ऑफ द कोड। क्लियर?